Good day, everybody. Joel here with your tropical update, and we are looking at the latest satellite imagery of number 11. Okay, number 11 already. Can you believe this? Tropical depression number 11. Storm, it really doesn't look like it's a big deal right now, but you know what? This depression is expected to become a tropical storm later today. Now, you can see dry air right in here. See all the darker areas? A little bit of dry air mixing in with it. But the dry air entrainment and the southeasterly shear, they're expected to give way, everybody, to a more conducive environmental condition by about 24 hours from now, when the cyclone will begin to move underneath the center of a synoptic scale upper level anticyclone. Now, what all this will do when it moves under it, this should result in the shear decreasing to near zero, an improvement in the upper level outflow pattern. Now, lower shear should reduce also the amount of the dry air that is the entrainment that's going in it right now. As you can see, dry air mixing in with it. Now, it's looking like strengthening could occur at least after that time, up until about 60 hours out from now. 60 hours out from now. So take right now, 60 out, all the way through the next 60 hours, this can strengthen. Now, by about 72 hours out and beyond that, all the global models show the system moving out from underneath the positive influence of that upper-level anticyclone. And it's going to run into then some southerly to southwesterly, vertical wind shear, and then start gradually weakening. Now, around 48 hours to 60 hours, it is going to strengthen. And around 60 hours, it's going to have 60 mile per hour winds. Now, it's not, you can't really go that far out and tell exactly how much it will strengthen. It might become a hurricane. It might not. It may stay at 60 mile per hour winds. We're going to have to wait and see. But I wanted you to be aware of all of this stuff. It is going to have a chance to strengthen for a good bit, but then it's going to hit a roadblock. All of the shear wind. And a lot of that dry air will probably come back at that time also. That's what it's looking like. But it's going to escape it for a while. And this depression number 11, it is expected to become a tropical storm later today. Now, as we go to the National Hurricane Center, here it is, Tropical Depression 11. The winds right now are 35 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure, 1,008 millibars. It's located 12.2 north, 42.9 west. It's moving west at 15 miles per hour. Now, as we look at the tracking map from the National Hurricane Center, you can see earlier in the morning today, this is where it was located, should turn into a tropical storm, as you can see, and remain that way until around 2 a.m. Saturday. Then, post-tropical, as it moves on up. Tracking map is showing what I primarily thought when I showed you yesterday's outlook, that I was thinking on just the European model, it's going to go up and over the islands this way. Not a direct hit at this time, but you are going to have some rain. You might have a little gusty winds right up in these areas here as it moves up and moves on out. Now, there are no watches and warnings at this time. No watches or warnings at this time. But we really got to keep our eyes on it, folks. You know how these things change with the blink of an eye. So, you know, right now, this is what the tracking is looking like for Tropical Depression number 11, soon to be a tropical storm. When we go over to the Pacific, you can see Alita here. It's still showing Alita as a hurricane, but their time is different from ours, and from everything that I've gone over, it's looking like Alita may be a tropical storm now, but as of this advisory at 2 a.m. PDT, it had 75 mile per hour winds. It was moving north-northwest at 13 miles per hour, but Alita, my friends, is going to be a tropical storm if it's not already, and it will just weaken more and more as it travels up this way. Now, look at everything else that's going on. My goodness gracious. Disturbance number one, as of now, is still elongated pressure, and it's about 1,300 miles southwest of the southern tip of Baja California, and it is continuing to produce a broad area of cloudiness and disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and the environmental conditions are conducive for development, and a tropical depression is likely to form within the next couple of days as this system is moving slow west-northwestward. 2 days, 70% chance. 5 days, 90% chance. Now, disturbance number two. This is a trough of low pressure. It's just west of the Gulf of Tempeque, southwestward for several hundred miles. It's a long, elongated trough, okay? Now, the environmental conditions appear conducive for development, and a tropical depression is likely to form during the next few days before this system reaches cooler waters over the weekend. Then it's looking like the system is forecast to move west-northwestward at about 15 miles per hour away from the coast of southwestern Mexico. 2 days, 60% chance. 5 days, 90% chance. Then we have disturbance number three. Boy, is the Pacific hot or what? It's another area of low pressure, and it is expected to form in a few days over the far eastern portion of the basin to the south of the coast of Central America. Now, conditions are expected to be conducive for development, and a tropical depression could form this weekend or early next week, while it moves generally west-northwestward just offshore the coast of Mexico. Zero chance in 2 days, 5 days, 60% chance. And we have a brand new disturbance number four right in this area here that popped up overnight. Now, this is forecast from near or west the border between the National Hurricane Center and Central Pacific Hurricane Center areas. Now, some subsequent gradual development of this system is possible later this week. It's going to move slowly westward in the Central Pacific Basin. Future information on this system will be included in tropical weather outlooks issued by the Central Pacific Hurricane Center. 2 days, zero. 5 days, 30% chance. I will keep my eyes on this for my friends around Hawaii. I want to say thank you to all of my new subscribers. Thank you to all my regular subscribers. I love each and every one of you very much, and I thank you for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed and you want all the latest weather updates concerning weather in general, severe weather, tropical weather, please click subscribe, click the bell, and make sure you check off all to ensure you get all the latest videos that I put out. Now, when we come over here right quickly as we get out of here to 11, everybody right in this area here, I'm going to tell you to watch very closely. If you're not in that area, everybody in this area, you need to keep up with it. And everybody, as this moves on up, it should come up like this. Move up and then get pulled up with a low system pressure area. Let's keep our eyes on it and make sure it doesn't. Everybody stay safe. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. We really need to keep our eyes on 11 at this time. Should be a tropical storm at some point today. Have much peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Stay safe, my friends, and thank you so much for watching.